Thank you for watching my new video blog. Today I'm in Paris, France, and today I want to talk about how to make profits as a starter with trading stocks. Since the interest on the saving accounts of the banks are very low, many people flee to the stock markets. They know that you can make some profits, and they heard about it, that you can make profit in the stock market, but you need to have a good strategy to make profits. And this is what most people lack. They just put their money in the stocks, they don't really have a strategy. They buy maybe too high when the stock is high, and they don't really have a good idea what they're doing. And it's a pity, because you can make a nice profit if you have a good strategy. And today I want to talk about what was my strategy when I started trading stocks, and what was successful for me when I was starting with trading stocks. And I first like to remind you that if you have a capital, maybe you start not with putting all your capital in the stock market. If you have, for example, 5,000 euros on your savings account, maybe start with 1,000. It's already very high, because you are putting 20% in the stocks, and mostly it is recommended to put 10% of your capital into investment if you don't have any experience with it. But you have to have an idea, and it's can I miss this money? If I lose the money, it will be like, will I be in trouble? For example, if you have a capital of 5,000 euros, when you lose 1,000, it is manageable. You still have 4,000 left for maybe buy a new fridge, something repaired to your car, or buy a new laptop, and all these things. So you have to think for yourself, is this money that I invest, is it, can I lose it? And keep in mind that we buy many things that we... And keep in mind that you buy or have bought in the past many things that lost their value very quickly. That you are already known to the thing of losing value. And that it's not very strange for you to buy things or invest things that lose their value a lot. Because I think by now most of you have bought a car, or maybe have bought a bicycle or a scooter, and you can see that maybe you have 5 years, you use it, and then the value is lost, then there's no value anymore. And or for example, how many people buy shoes, wear it 100 euros, and they walk for 6 months on it, and after 6 months the shoes are worn out, and basically there's no any value left of the shoes. So see it in this way when you start to invest money, because it can be a threshold for many people when they, if they want to put their money into an investment or not. And keep this in mind when you start to invest, because for many people there's a threshold to invest, I noticed, and they say, well, I don't, it's too risky, stocks are very risky, I don't want to touch it, I will lose all my money. Don't think in this way. You can make good money if you have a good strategy, and this is what I'm going to talk about next. The first thing that you have to do is, when you start trading stocks, is you have to invest in companies. So what I do is, when I search for a stock that I want to buy, or a company that I want to invest in, it has to be a company that I know, or that I know at least what they're doing, and I always check their history. For me it's very important to see how long has the company been around, and then if I see that this is a very old company, for example, you can say Coca-Cola, it's a very old company, and it has a reason why it's very old, because Coca-Cola is a product that is very interesting to people, they like it, and in my opinion, I can imagine over 100 years this product is still around. Maybe in another form, maybe they change the bottle, maybe they change the colors of the logo, but the product is Coca-Cola, and this will be around. At least that's my expectation when I see that the company has such a long history. So when you search for a stock, you always have to think, what is the company providing? And I always try to look for companies that are providing things that are very basic. For example, oil, for example, like cars, or for example, you can also invest in companies that are, for example, I invest in steel companies a lot. I assume that these companies will be around in 100 years. I don't believe that steel will, that we will stop using steel, because it's a very important product. It's a very important material. I don't invest for example in companies like Google or Facebook or Twitter. I don't see them being around within 10 years. I don't think that their product is that strong to survive the next 10 years. I prefer to invest in things that have a use that is more, that cannot be taken over by somebody else easily. Now, the next thing is that what I do is that I search for companies that are low price, that when the price has dropped recently, I buy them. Because when the price is low, it is a chance to, when the price will go back up, that you can sell them again. And you can say when you have to buy the stock when the price is undervalued. For example, a company had bad news and suddenly the price of the stock drops. But you still see that this company is a good company, but there just are things going around in this company, there are things going on, bad things. For example, I invest in the flight company KLM, and recently the price of the stock dropped because there were problems with the cooperating company that they work together with our friends, and so the price dropped. People are, investors are insecure, and they think that the price will drop lower, and so they sell. So this is an opportunity for you to buy a stock. I see the company KLM, I fly with them a lot of times, and I see that's a very, very good company. I see that they provide a lot of service, and for the future, I think that they are, it's a secure company to invest in. So to make sure that I want to buy this stock, I check their history. I take, for example, the 5-year history of the company, of the stock price, and then I decide, then I check what was the highest price and what was the lowest price. And for example, I see when the highest price was $7 or euros, and the lowest price was, for example, 3 euros. The price is now, say, 4 euros. Then I can imagine that this price will be on average. I look what the average price will be, and this is 5 euros. So this is for me reason to buy this stock, because I expect that the price will not go back to 7 soon, but will go back to 5 in a short time, because this is the average price. And when a company is undervalued, I expect that they will go back to 5 within a few months. So this is an opportunity to make money. You buy the stock for 4 and you can sell them for 5. It means that you make $1 per stock profit. I recommend that you buy stocks in a high volume and in a round amount, say 50, 100, 200, because this makes it easy for you if you're not so strong in calculating, like me. I'm not that good in calculating. It makes it easy to remind you what your profit will be. For example, I bought at $4, and then one day I saw the price going back to 5, and I knew that this was the moment to sell, because I made $1 per stock profit, so it means 100 euro profits. And this is the best thing that you can do if you don't want to pay too much attention to this, to the price. You can also put a sale order. You can say, okay, I bought them for 4, I want to sell them for 5. I put a sale order, and you can put this in your broker account, and you can say, okay, I want to sell when the price is 5. I want to sell all my 100 KLM stocks for $5. So it means that I made $100 of profit. Try to spread also. What I do is I search for 10 companies, attend different companies, for example, like a flight company or an insurance company, a bank, a steel, an oil company, and I try to make a diverse portfolio so that I have 10 different companies with offering 10 different services. This means that the chance that the price are all dropping is low. And like I say, when you have 10 companies, maybe oil went up, you can sell your oil stocks, and maybe your bank stocks are going lower, so you have to wait with selling them. But when you have such a diverse portfolio, there's always something happening. There's always one going up and one going down, unless there's a very bad situation like economical crisis or maybe a big terroristic attack. This will affect all the stocks. Of course, there's no guarantee. It can also happen that the stocks will go down for a long time. Patience is very important in this. You have to be patient. Don't sell when your portfolio is at an undervalued moment. Just have patience. Wait. Make sure that your life is not depending on your stocks. Just see it as you have to spread your investments and see stocks as one of them. See the stock investment as something that you have time for. You can say, okay, I can wait 6 months with this money. I can store it there and I can check the price and I can wait until the price goes up. And if it doesn't go up, I can wait even more. Don't see it as something that you want to make quick money off. There are other ways of making quick money. I will cover that in another video. It's called Forex trading, but with the stocks, it's more a short, long-term kind of thing. You need to pay attention to your stocks because maybe you lose a peak when, for example, if the price goes up in 2 weeks and you are not checking your stocks, the price of your stocks, you can lose the profit. So you have to pay attention to it, but maybe a few times in the week will be okay. You don't have to check it daily. I do it, but I enjoy it. But maybe you are there, okay, I want to invest, I want to make a profit out of it, I put the sale, and then you can let it put it there and wait until the profit comes in. Now, when you make a profit, the trap that most people are stepping in is they think, okay, I made a profit, and they get the profit out of their stocks, they get it into cash, and they spend it. And this is not a smart way of investing. Of course, you don't take the money back from your profit, you put it in new stocks. And now my suggestion is what you do is you don't buy these $3 to $5 or euro stocks, you buy the more valuable stocks. For example, you buy a stock that is worth $20 or $30. Because this means that this stock is high valued. And this means that it's a stronger stock than the stocks are of $4 or $5. So it's wise to then start buying stocks that are higher price but at this moment undervalued. So say, for example, you want to buy a stock of an oil company, but it is now $25, but it used to be, the average used to be $40. It is a very smart investment because you can, with this, you have a high value stock in your portfolio, and maybe they offer you also a lot of dividends, which is great because the dividend is something you just get for investing your money. It's your fee. And the higher the stock is in price, the higher is the dividend. So even if you don't really actively trade, you still get money out of the stock. And this is, of course, a nice way of making extra money. Okay, I hope that you have now a little bit of an idea what my strategy was. I hope I explained it well. I say good luck with investing, with starting investing, and I hope that you keep these rules in mind. And for now, I say from Paris, France, thank you for watching, and see you next time.